Who's the best one on the team right now? Everybody can raise their hand. Everybody can have confidence in themselves. That's the first thing. That's the first thing I'm talking about, confidence. Like believing in yourself. Like all your life, there's gonna be some people that's doubting you, some people that don't believe in you, but you gotta believe in yourself. Keep yourself going forward. How many of y'all know what a sports scholarship is? Well, if you love basketball, that's what the dream is, to get a full scholarship to. I know me growing up, if I ain't have a scholarship, I probably won't go into college. My family don't have money like that. Scholarship, that's a lot of money right there. So, I mean, if you really serious about the basketball game, then you need to be working hard like every day. Like I said, don't let nobody tell you that you can't do something. Me growing up, like high school, like ninth grade, like Mr. Wright was saying, like ninth grade, like, a lot of people on the team really ain't like me because, you know, I was a young boy. I really wouldn't be playing JV, but I was playing straight varsity, like coming out of middle school. Like, that's rare. Nobody really doing that no more. And I was really playing, like, scoring, everything. And then, like, my 10th grade year, that was, like, my breakout year. I averaged, like, 25 points. But nobody see the work I put in behind the scenes, like, practice, shooting in the gym, working out with my brother right here. Everything, like my brother right here, he played for Butler too. I said, when I was little, I used to always come to his game and he was playing. And that was my role model right there, looking up to him. Wanting to be like him, wanting to be better than him. Like to this day, like my first time probably being one-on-one was like when I was in ninth grade, 10th grade. I can never really be the one-on-one. That's the goal, my motivation right there with him. To get past the hump. I'm going fast forward to 12th grade. We was one of the best teams in the city. Y'all know Lane, right? We saw them go ahead on Lane. So 12th grade, I was supposed to go to Florida Atlantic. That's a Division I school in Florida. But some things that happened, some things went sideways. And I had a backtrack and I had to go to JUCO. The JUCO was like a junior college, right? Where people go for like 2 years to get like their grades right or just to get like some better offers. So that's basically what I did. So when I did that, I had a good year, my first year. And I had a lot of scholarship offers from a lot of schools, Georgia Southern, Georgia, school in Cleveland, California, and I ended up going to Cal Berkeley, which is like the number one public school in the country. So they real big on academics, not just athletics. So I chose to go there. I chose to go to that school. And I'm talking about my sophomore year. So my first year there, going into the year, and I'm talking to my brother, like, you know, we thinking, like, I'm going to play a lot, like I did in high school, which really wasn't the case. Like, I had to change my whole game. I had to see things from a different side of the pole. So, basically, me and the coach, we had all those differences, but he had one side, I had a side there, too. So throughout the year, I wasn't really playing as much as I thought I should. And my brother was just telling me, like, stay with it. I was ready to give up, I'll be honest. I was ready to give up. I was ready to transfer. I said to my brother, yeah, I'm a transfer. I ain't staying here. Like, I ain't playing. This, that, and the third. Just making excuses, but it really was my fault. I was practicing hard. I was playing good, but when I got in the game, I wasn't really playing how I played. I was playing scary sometimes, shy, scared to make a mistake. And with basketball, you can't do that. You just gotta go out there and play, or you're not gonna be affected out there. So throughout the year, it kept getting better and better. Then I started playing good. How many of y'all know Lonzo Ball? I'm pretty sure all y'all know him. I know him. He's supposed to be like number one pick in the draft next year. Played against him, played real good. Had like 15 points against UCLA. That was one of the best teams in the country. How many of y'all know Markel Fultz? He's supposed to be no one picking the draft, too. Played against him. Still played good. Won that game, too. I talked to him, like, on a daily basis. We talk every now and then. So, past that. So, next year, it will be my junior year. So, I'm looking to have a big year next year. But see, that comes from working hard. Like, this whole summer, I've been working out every day, getting up shots, in the gym, running. Take a lot of hard work, man. A lot of people think that stuff was just handed to me, given to me, and thinking I was good all my life when really I got better every year and I had to strive to get where I'm at now. Did nothing come easy for me. How many of y'all want to get out of Augusta?
Y'all heard that?
It's good. I mean, ain't nothing wrong with Augusta, but people gotta realize that it's bigger things than Augusta. Like I could have stayed and went to GRU. They wanted me to come to GRU, but I told myself, nah, I want to get out of Augusta, so that's why I went all the way to California. You gotta think about it, that's on the whole other side of the country. I don't see my family every day. Like, this is my first time seeing my brother in a minute. I'm gonna stay in California all year. I don't really get to come home like that. So that's big, being out here for the summer, you know, talking to y'all. What high school y'all plan on going to?
Richmond.
Lane. You want to go to Butler? Everybody want to go to Butler? You want to go to Butler? Hey, what's up? I'm gonna ask y'all some questions now, all right? So who y'all think gonna win the championship this year? Cam. I got another question. Who the best player in the NBA right now? Hey, raise your hand if your parents work. Raise your hand if your parents got a job at work. You know, y'all working hard in this basketball stuff, you know, going to college and probably going to the NBA, y'all can change that. I can make your mom not have to work no more. That's my goal. I don't want my mom to work no more. She worked all her life. She working now to this day. You got a question? Anybody got some questions?
Y'all don't get shot, man. I brought them here. Y'all go out. I got her at a funeral, man. Y'all go ahead and get an action, young man.
Anybody got any questions?
Y'all got any questions?
University of California, Berkeley. Not off. This is like my second time being down here all year. I'll be a junior next year. Oh,
Adam Graves,
right? You're right, Graves. My major legal studies. But Graves. Graves is big, man. Like, I gotta have good grades there. I wanna play basketball. Like Mr. Wright said, if y'all don't have good grades and y'all the best player in the city, y'all still gonna be playing in the city after y'all graduate. Y'all still gonna be here in the park playing. Okay. I gotta have grades, man. But yeah, NCAA, they always change the rules from like requirements you gotta make for your grades, your GPA, and your ACT scores and all of that. That's you gotta make sure y'all stay on top of y'all grades, man. What's up, bro? Butler, 2015. What's up, Andrew?
What is your daily schedule?
In college?
Yeah.
That's a good question, all right. All right, my daily schedule. So normally in the beginning of the season, we practice 2-a-days. So basically we have practice at 6 a.m. in the morning. So I'll probably get up like 5:30, you know, brush my teeth, whatever, go to the gym, practice at 6 a.m. After practice, it might end like 7:30. Then I might have to grab something to eat real quick, got tutoring like at 8 o'clock. After tutoring, I might have class like at 9:30 to like 11:30. Then we got practice at 12 to 3, that's the little time slot. So 12 to 3, that's practice. So after that, after 12 to 3, you might have a class like at 3:30, so you gotta take a shower, grab something to eat, right back to class at 3:30. Then like at 5 o'clock, you might have tutoring again, or you might have a group session or a study session. That's like my daily routine, right? That's like every day, right there.
Is it difficult balancing being a student athlete? Is it difficult?
Yeah, it's very difficult. I think it's hard to be a regular student because you got practice, you got games, you got classes, you got tutoring, you got your work, and you gotta be playing good. If you're not playing good, that can affect your mind, your head, that can affect your grade. So it all is playing one part.
How about them girls?
Yeah, you gotta stay focused. You gotta watch out for the girls. They right, you gotta watch out for the girls. You gotta stay focused. Yeah, you gotta stay focused. What's up, bro?
Yeah, at times, because, you know, in college, like, we travel a lot. So we might be in L.A. one day, then the next day we might be in, like, Oregon. So on the road, your tool to travel with you, you got to bring your laptop. You still got to do work on the road. Even though you're on the road playing, you still got to do your work. You still help held accountable to do all your work no matter what. What's up, brother? I mean, college scouting. Out of high school, it was about like 10, 15. Then once I went to my junior college, it boosted up to like 25, 30. Like a lot of schools wanted me. What's up, Mr. Rutt?
Like, you were one of the best players in Augusta, but when you started getting recruited by colleges, like say for instance, when you went to Lawson, how many boys on the team that you felt like were the best in their school, but they didn't make it to a big school like you? And then when you got to college, how many players on that team skill set, man, yours, meaning that I know when you go to the high level, all the best players be there.
Yeah. You're right, at Lawson, it was still some good players there that probably the best player on their team, in their high school team, just like me. And especially in Cali, like, everybody on my team was able to go, like, they was good. Like, we got one of my teammates going to the draft this year, Ivan Rabb. He's supposed to be a lottery pick this year. Whoa. So, I mean, we had some boys that could go. So every day in practice, you had to bring your A game.
Word on the street, you know
Jalen
Brown that played for
them. Yeah, JB, yep. I played with him too in the sophomore camp. Anybody know Jalen Brown that played for the Boston Celtics? He went to my school too. Say it again. Can I beat Kyrie in basketball? Yeah, I think so. What's up, bro? Of all the colleges, why California? That's a good question, man. But me, my brother, my mom, we had visited over the, like, in April last year, we had visited the school. We liked the campus, first of all. And it was the number one public school in the universe, so academics, they was big on that. If you get your degree from that school, you're going to get a good job. It was a high major Division I school and a good conference, the Pac-12, one of the best conferences in the country. The coach was real down to earth with me, they kept it real with me. And overall, we just liked the atmosphere. We felt like it was family. Yes, ma'am.
When you get big and start
playing
with Steph Curry, don't forget about my
time. I'm not. I got you. I'm not. What's up, bro? Say it again.
Have you ever go against Steph Curry?
That's the plan. I hope to get there. I met him before. I met Steph Curry before.
What do you do to take your mind off of basketball?
What I do to take my mind off basketball? Chilling with my friends, my brother, my family. Mostly just chilling with my family to get my mind off basketball. Just chilling with my family. Any more questions?
Do you think you can beat LeBron James?
Do I think I can beat LeBron James? Yeah, I think so. I told you I gotta have that confidence. You're never supposed to say you can't beat nobody. Like, if I ask you right now, can you beat me? You're supposed to say yes. You gotta have that mindset. Hey, you think you can beat me one-on-one? You think so? For real? All right, there we go. That's what you're supposed to say. You gotta have that confidence. If you don't have that confidence, you're not gonna go nowhere. You gotta have confidence. Any more questions? That's it. All right, man, thank you. I appreciate it, man.